Welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios, and joining us in studio is Mitchell Smith, the President and CEO of Global Energy Metals. Mitchell, always great to chat with you.
Excellent. Thanks very much for having us.
And joining us on Skype right now is Marshall MacNabb. He's the Director of Research and Development for MWH Geo Surveys. And Marshall, great to talk to you as well.
Thanks for having me on.
So we'll talk to Marshall in just a second, but Mitchell, let's get caught up to date on what you're doing in Nevada. So summer program is over now. Tell me a little bit about what happened in the summer.
Yeah, for sure. So we had a very, very productive and busy summer. We were able to do a site visit to the Nevada project, to the Lovelock mine in Nevada, just about 150 kilometers away from the Tesla Gigafactory. Okay. While we were there, we were able to do some surveying, some sampling of surface sampling of rocks on site, outside of the adits. We did some underground mapping and sampling work. There was previous studies done by Nevada Sunrise, our partner there. Okay. We've also partnered with a group called Canada Cobalt Works and are utilizing their Re2Ox process to be able to test and better understand the metallurgical properties of the asset there. And now we're just started and wrapping up actually a drone survey, both a mag survey and orthophoto work that we'll get into some detail on that as well.
Yeah, that's where we're getting Marshall back in with us again from MWH Geo Surveys. Marshall, explain to us a little bit about the technology that's involved in utilizing a drone in the mining industry.
Absolutely. So the drone industry has really is a really great tool to use in the mining industry. And that's because, especially in properties like this property, it's very inaccessible. It's difficult to survey the terrain on foot. And so what drones provide is they provide a platform that lets us collect really high quality data that's noise free, and it allows us to collect that data across very rugged topography in a really economical way. So it's really opened up exploration opportunities doing these magnetic surveys suspended from the drone platform that otherwise would have either been very cost prohibitive or would have been very difficult to collect clean data on foot.
Marshall, are there different types of drones that you would utilize on a property? Does it determine what you're looking for at that particular property for what type of drone you want to use?
So we operate two different drone platforms. The first is a fixed wing survey specific mapping drone that takes high resolution photos from a fixed altitude above the ground. Those photos are then stitched together to create a high resolution orthophoto or orthomosaic and a digital surface model. So that provides a high accuracy 3D representation of the property, as well as a very detailed orthophoto, which is basically just a zoomed in version of an aerial photo. And that allows us to really assess the property, and we can use that 3D model to plug into our rotary drones. And those are hexacopters that have a payload capacity, and they suspend the magnetic platform, and we fly that at a fixed ground height over the surface to collect the magnetic data.
And can those type of drones be used anywhere? Does it have to be certain climates, or are they pretty well usable all around the world?
They're usable all around the world. We've used them as far north as the Arctic Circle. We've also used them in Saharan Africa. So we've had really good success using those drones globally for different mining operations or exploration operations. Now, there are different challenges involved in working in those different environments, namely temperatures. The battery life can decrease in cold temperatures and can be a challenge in warmer temperatures. But by and large, they're very effective globally.
Yeah. The other challenge will be keeping a jacket on the guy who's running it, for sure. That's the other one as well. It's really interesting considering that there hasn't been any modern work done on your property in Nevada. How important is it to do things like this as far as the drone footage is concerned, the stuff on the ground, the underground mapping and all that, to make sure that you just don't start plugging stuff everywhere and thinking, hey, let's see what happens?
Exactly. And so the program this summer was really all about all about de-risking and having a better understanding of the potential for the project, and really be able to use this data and the drone surveys, for instance, to be able to target a drill program for the future. And so, using technology that is really breaking edge and industry leading groups like MWH is something that we believe is very important for the sector, and certainly want to be able to utilize technology like this at all of our projects.
And Marshall, last question to you. Are you finding an increase in people that are using your company or other companies like yours specifically, that you're seeing a big uptick as far as trying to be as cost effective as possible?
Absolutely. So as I mentioned before, the using drone surveys allows us to conduct magnetic surveys in areas that would be really difficult to do with conventional means by foot. We're an exploration company with a history in ground surveying, and this drone platform has opened up numerous opportunities to us that would have been very challenging to do via conventional methods. So we've noticed a big boom in industry adoption very rapidly.
Well, it's fabulous technology and very interesting. And Cannon, thank you enough for spending some time with us and so we can learn a little bit more about it. Good to meet you, Marshall.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and great to see you as well, Mitchell.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
All right, Mitchell Smith, President and CEO of Global Energy Metals, and Marshall MacNabb, Director of Research and Development for MWH Geo Surveys.